has four wins, no losses. Jamie Hislop to Pavlinski. A long shot. Fuhrer picked it off, and Grant Fuhrer hangs onto the puck. A lot of face stoppages in this first period. Seems a little tight. Now a little high sticking between Lindstrom and Pavlinski. And now Big Keith Hansen comes in, and the sticks get up a little bit. Coffey and Conroy. Now some gloves are coming off. Hansen throwing punches. Now everybody's got their gloves on. And Semenko watching from the bench says, why? Am I not out there right now?
I was just going to say that that's about the first time I've ever seen anybody give it to Lindsman, and Lindsman turned his back and he hit him again on the shoulder, and Lindsman walked away from it. Then he bumped into a player and turned around and someone gave it to him again, and then finally he's in the middle of it. You know, Lindsman, I don't think there's ever been a better skating center in the National Hockey League, particularly those first one, two, three strides. He has generates more power, has the quickest start of just about any hockey player I've ever seen.
Well, we're having trouble prying them apart. The guy on top weighs 215 pounds and is 6'5". That's Keith Hansen, 26-year-old defenseman. And there's Ken Lindsman checking to see if he's been cut there. Lindsman considerably smaller than Big Hansen, who cut up Lindsman quite a bit there. Now they might go some more. He wants to get Pavlinski, and Pavlinski takes Lindsman on. Well, you got to get Lindsman credit for starting another one, but he's going to take the worst of this one. Pavlinski and Lindsman. Hislop is trying to hold Huddy away. He was trying to help Lindsman. And they've already got Hansen at the penalty box. Well, Hansen's going to get the heave-ho tossed out of the hockey game. There's Pavlinski and Lindsman. Now, it was over. Now Pavlinski throws another one. It looked to be over, and Lindsman skated by Pavlinski, and something said and done, and away they went again.
Well, he's known around the league as the instigator, and I think Philadelphia actually got rid of him because as good a hockey player as he is, he had about 300 minutes in penalties every year, and he really, really did hurt the club.